Okay, trial and error, as we've been doing for the last 3 to 4 or 5 years, the peppers around the side of the house tend to grow pretty well. I put plastic down this year. It is July 21st, 2015. It is 5 minutes before 11 a.m. There's a variety of peppers. I couldn't even tell you which are which. I know there's some bell peppers out here, jalapeno peppers, maybe a cayenne pepper or two. I got the green bell peppers and the orange bell peppers. The orange, basically, you just have to let the green pepper stay on the vine and it'll change orange or red if you have red peppers. That's all that is, just the color takes extra time on the vine. I wanted to show you guys the view we have here. As far as I can see, Monsanto corn. It's about 150 acres across. And the side and back is another 150 acres of corn. Monsanto corn now, remember. It's man-made, you know, man is better than God. Yeah, right. Okay, I wanted to show you the flowers again, how they go through their stages. The torch sunflower, some people call it the other thing, south of the border sunflower too. But see how they're dying off, but they're coming back, they're blooming constantly too. And our growth season in West Tennessee is around mid to late October. Might go a little bit further. I got a different type of sunflower. I didn't realize I had seeds out here. That one up there is about 14 feet tall. Didn't realize it'd be that big. That one's big. But you see the yellow face, I call it? Those took forever to open up. They just opened up within the last week. Plants are dying off and growing back. The pumpkins is a waste. We're not even taking care of these things and spraying them with anything at all. Paper, usually it's water and baking soda for disease, water and ivory soap for insects, because look at how they kind of start decimating the okra plants. Look at the leaves, how the holes are through there from them eating on them. I gave a good douse about 2 days ago and they don't land on them anymore. There's a bee. So you have to take care of the stuff once you got it growing, but like I said, we're gonna let the pumpkins go. Just too many, and we didn't know they were pumpkins to begin with. They were supposed to, I thought, zucchini, but anywho, we might get one or two pumpkins from the back ones over there. Look at all the butterflies around here. That's why I like too. Lots of them, and they're usually the bigger butterflies. I've been spraying with the ivory soap and water and that for insects, like I say. And then the water and baking soda is for the disease. And now these are purple pole beans. We've had so many of these. We had a major problem with these. These were all dead. I have to say, they were all brown. There's one plant in there that looks like it's dead. But see, they're mixed in there. It would be great for mulch. But the thing is, I have to get that out and put it in my compost pile, those leaves. The Canelli bean, I found out, is a spring cool temperature bean. Even though it's growing right now, the heat out here is going to get up to 91 today. It's going to cool off for a couple days. But the heat out here is what's killing these off because it's too hot. With this plastic, makes it another 10 degrees hotter. The cucumbers, the straight eight right here, has been producing a lot. Those, we've gone so many, we've pickled about 36 jars at least. Just a lot. It's another thing we learned from. Instead of having like 6 to 8 plants, I will have 3 maximum. Honeydew melons, we thought they were cantaloupe, but these are honeydew. There is one more cantaloupe growing. Right there, I think it is. Yeah. We cut one open. It wasn't quite sweet enough, but it was good. We're going to let this one go until it's really, really ripe. And like I said, these are honeydew. We thought they were bad cantaloupe, but no, these are honeydew melons. It's 2 different plants down here I planted. All from seed. Everything out here is from seed. The sugar baby. Right there, a big round one there. Looks like a bowling ball. I can't see on this viewfinder with the crack. You guys will see it better than I can. It's around there somewhere. And then there's another one growing. Somewhere in there, right? It's another dark green one. Round one, like a bowling ball. And then those Jubilee watermelons in the back. We've eaten 3 of them. Gave one away. And there's one more back there somewhere, right there. And those are weighing 20 pounds or more. You can't get a watermelon like that in a store, especially China Mart. Zucchini had aphids. I've been treating those and getting rid of them. Now you see all the green is coming back. They're growing back after they've been treated. Okay, they were all looking really like that right there. that's coming out. Something like that right there. But then look at the green growth growing in behind them, because you know, you treat them with the baking soda and water. That's a natural thing to help with the disease that they might get, brown spot. And then they grow back, like you're seeing them. We're getting zucchini back, getting some golden ones. There's a couple green ones in there. I'm not gonna hold them open. Purple hull peas, I half-heartedly planted some more. I didn't realize they will grow because they weren't, I didn't think they were dried out enough. They were off the pot here, and they were semi, like, I don't know if you, again, I can't see that. There's one there that's spotted looking, right there, like that one. They'll be moist still, and they're supposed to be dried out, and that's when you plant for seed. Well, I planted three, and guess what? Three of them are growing here. So, I got three more, or four, I'm sorry, I planted four. I got four more purple hull peas growing right here. Didn't intend these to happen. Over there, I have two or three seeds in each one of those locations, and I just planted one seed. Like I told you before, the seeds from Heirloom Solutions, I've planted one seed, and I've had one plant for each one, and then I figured, well, I'll do like some people were suggesting, just to try it. I planted two and three, and like I say, two and three are growing out of each station, and that might be one reason why it's kind of like choking itself off here. But see, there's a black-eyed pea there, but you see the green still coming up again? Again, I can't see it on this viewfinder. I got it in that area. There's a green stem coming up out of the ground yet. And two others that are, or three others that are brown, look like they're choking themselves off. Black-eyed peas out here picking every couple days. Sometimes twice a day for a while, and then we let off, and then once a day. The sunflowers around here, these are Titan with the dark face. Bees all over these all the time. I mean constantly, usually. And butterflies. But those Titan sunflowers, not Titan, torch sunflowers are the orange flowered ones. Those ones that attract all the butterflies. Next year, that's gonna be like that all the way on three sides of the garden. Only the face of the garden, which is closest to the house, won't have them. These are a couple of tomato plants that were, again, from seed. See how well they're doing. They've been out here for about 5 days, maybe a week. And I put cages on them now, just so, you know, for in the future. Others that didn't make it, not worrying about it. Pepper plant there. Supposed to be a pepper plant there. There's a small tomato right there underneath that sunflower. Another small tomato somewhere around there. And then four pepper plants. So, the cannelli bean, that's the one I showed over there. It's a cool weather plant. Like, so I might plant one in late August into September and see if it'll grow out here right where this one was. These are Jackson Wonder beans. One plant, one seed there, and that was a takeoff on this right here. And we should have a pretty, and here's a, I don't recall which bean this is right now. This is where I've had the giant beans right there. One down here and two there, and I even soaked one after about 3 weeks. I soaked one overnight and put it down, nothing. So I know this is not that giant scarlet bean. I don't know what it is, a bean, but I don't know now for sure. I'm pretty sure it's not the Jackson Wonder bean. This is a butterscotch squash. That's a butterscotch squash. Then this is a different type of squash. And that's a different type of squash. So, as the zucchini was looking bad, I figured, well, I'll just plant these out here, and they're coming up already. Like I said, third week in July right now. And we got all the way until middle, end of October. So we got about 3 months for growing yet. So the purple pole beans, we're getting, now we're letting them all go to seed basically. I mean, we have seeds for 100 years right now. Right now we have seeds for at least 100 years, plus every year for the next five or six years. From Solutions from Science, I should get $100 worth of seeds, which is basically 10 packs. And I don't need all those, and plus I'm clearing seeds. Now this is the tomato plant. This one right here, let me show you. These four right here are from Kmart. And you see how worms got at these, the hornworm, especially the third one there. You see how it almost decimated it completely, cut it off. And it still sometimes seems like it's having challenges. I've already thrown off the tomato that was already bad. This one here had a hornworm on it, got that off. This one's doing better than this one, the one before it. I had a hornworm on that pepper plant right there. Got that off. Had two on this one. Got them off. Had one on this one just recently. Or two of them recently. And I've been putting in a bottle I had with chlorine tablets for the pool, and there was just like powder dust in there, and I filled it with water. And there's about 8 or 9 of those green worms in there, which really smells pretty damn bad right now. And I'm just taking that to the garbage dump. But look at that big one. That's my green tomato. Here in another, well, let's see if I can get it on here. Right there's a big green tomato in there. There's two of them in there. That one's gonna be my green tomato in about another week, maybe two. I don't think I'm gonna go 2 weeks with that. I don't want to take no chance of any worms getting into that stuff. But these are big. I don't think these are beefsteak. These are supposed to be beefsteak, those four from Kmart. This one I think is, I don't know. I don't remember anymore. I mean, there's earlier videos. If you want to go back and watch the videos, I explain exactly what's planted where. You see, like, my sunflowers are on three sides. Those are just the Titan sunflowers on the right side and the back, and I had them mixed in there. But then I had some old sunflower seeds, which weren't from Heirloom Solutions, but I put them out there, and you see how they look. They're tall. See, that's one from Heirloom Solutions, the tall with the dark face. That dark face one? Oh, that's the one that's 14 feet tall. But, well, maybe they're all the same, man. Maybe their face darkened. But these were all bright yellow. The faces were bright yellow. They're just now maybe darkening, but those are from a pack I had bought, perhaps at China Mart a couple years back, and they've just been sitting in the freezer. Yeah, I think that's what that is too. It's not from Heirloom Solutions. See, look at them. Bees all over. Butterflies. I love these big butterflies. And like I said, that's what's helped pollinate everything out here. So that's the garden 2015. Been very, very bountiful already. And we got at least another, July to August to September to October. We got 3 more months of gathering out of this garden. So, you know, this is nice. And we're sharing it with people. We're not buying, we're not selling it to anybody. We're not just throwing it away. Nothing goes to waste. Those flower heads in the middle of those torch sunflowers, I can't focus in here. I'm going to zoom in and see if I can see something. You see the dark, let me get closer. I can, the dark head ones in there somewhere. Anyway, those are the ones you get your seeds from. Okay, you got to pluck them out with like tweezers and you get a seed from them. And I got a bunch I planted up by the house too. Oh, there's a little, it's like a moth butterfly that landed on my finger. Be nice. I wish one of these would lay it on my finger. So anyway, this is the garden 2015. My solar panel with my little solar generator. I run my freezer for about 4 hours, 5 hours on it, and it really great pulls the power from it because it's not meant for running that much power at one time. But it helps, you know, 4 hours a day, every about 4 days a week, 5 days a week, times a month. You know, it's 20 days out of the month. It's not running on that electrical line. So, oh yeah, these things get hummingbirds over here all the time too, by the way. There you go.